discuss about the drugs used in the GI care systems. Now, what is GIT drugs are? In this chapter, a very important drug is used for peptic ulcer disease. There are many diseases in this system. The functions of the digestive, excretory, endocrine, exocrine, and so on. These functions are targets of several important classes of the drugs. Some of these drugs are have been discussed previously. Now, today's topic is how to treat acid peptic disease. Now, first of all, you have know about the what is peptic ulcer. Peptic ulcer is a break in the gastric or duodenal mucosa. It is an acute or chronic benign ulceration occurring in a portion of the digestive tract, which is accessible to gastric secretion. In GIT, the peptic ulcer and gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERD, chemotherapy induced emesis, diarrhea, constipation, and many drugs described in the chapters also find application in the treatment of GI disorders. So, come to the point, what is peptic ulcer? Peptic ulcer is a break in the gastric or duodenal mucosa. It is an acute or chronic benign ulceration occurring in a portion of the digestive tract, which is accessible gastric secretions. Now, it is very important that there are many types of the ulcerations. Today, we are discussing about the two types of the ulcers. Number one is gastric ulcers. Number two, duodenal ulcers. Gastric ulcers is very common in our setup. So, which is the pathogenesis of the peptic ulcer disease? Factors that play an important role include gastric acid and pepsin secretions, decreased mucosal resistance to acid, and Helicobacter pylori. Now, epigastric distress occur in 45 to 60 minutes after meal in case of the gastric ulcers. And it relieved by food, antacids, or vomiting. This is the sign of the gastric ulcer. Gastric ulcer is, it is epigastric distress occurring after having meal between 45 to 60 minutes. And it relieved by food, antacid, or vomiting. Now, sign of the duodenal ulcers is epigastric distress occur on empty stomach. Please understand this point. In case of the gastric ulcer, epigastric distress occur 45 to 60 minutes after meal, while epigastric distress occur on empty stomach in case of duodenal ulcer. And it is relieved by food or alkali or vomit. This is the picture shows the upper one is the healthy stomach and lower one the picture of the stomach, which is duodenal ulcer and stomach ulcer. Stomach ulcer or peptic ulcer. So this is the clear picture shows the difference between the healthy stomach and ulcer stomach. This is the peptic ulcer disease. Now, what are the common causes of the peptic ulcers? There are many types of the peptic ulcers causes. In number one is alcoholic beverages. And family history, stress-induced peptic ulcer, excess stress, or low levels of melatonin, hypercalcemia, and NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, and Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. These are the common causes of the peptic ulcers. So these are the common factors. Peptic ulcer is as I have told you before. The stress, H. pylori, alcohol, smoking, and gastric ulcers. What are the sign and symptom of the gastric ulcer? Are if anyone who is having the ulcer, then he will weight loss, HCl normal or hyposecretions, pain half hour after meals. This picture shows the difference between the gastric ulcers, duodenal ulcers, stress ulcers. And common factors are shown in this picture. Now, what are the therapeutic options of the treating peptic ulcer disease? In peptic ulcer disease, antacids, H2 receptors, mucosal protective agents, and PPIs are the main options we have to treat the peptic ulcer disease. Auxiliary gastric glands, mucus, neck cell secretes mucus, peptic chief cell secretes pepsinogen, parietal or occipital cell secretes hydrochloric acid and intrinsic factors, pyloric glands secretes mucus, pepsinogen, gastrin. In stomach, acid peptic disease, gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERD, peptic ulcer, gastric and duodenal, stress-related mucosal injury. In aggressive factors, acid pepsin bile, and defensive factors are mucus, bicarbonates, prostaglandins, blood flow, process of regeneration after cellular injury. These are the causes of the peptic ulcers: Helicobacter pylori, NSAIDs, and hypersecretory states like endocrine tumors producing gastrin, Zollinger-Ellison syndrome. And if any severe tissue injury, extensive burn on intracranial surgery, this picture shows stomach peptic ulcer due to Helicobacter pylori infection. Now, let's come to the point. How will you diagnose the peptic ulcer? No doubt, endoscopy is one of the best option to diagnose the peptic ulcer disease. And various non-invasive methods are serology and urea breath test. In serology, urea breath test, biopsy shows the sample which is H. pylori discovered on the gastric mucosa. Now, what are the drug treatment of the peptic ulcer?
As I have told you that acid peptic disease included peptic ulcer, gastric and duodenal and gastropharyngeal reflux, GERD, and pathological hypersecretory states such as the Zollinger-Ellison syndrome.
Now we have drug options are agents enhancing mucosal defenses, two acid anti-secretory agents, and agents used for eradication of the H. pylori infection. In agents enhancing mucosal defenses system, antacids, bismuth, prostaglandins, sucralfate. And acid anti-secretory agents are H2 blockers, PPIs. And third one, agents used for eradication of the H. pylori is, we have the options of the antibiotics. Classification of the drugs used in peptic ulcer is, I have previously told that you drugs that inhibit gastric acid secretion, drugs that neutralize gastric acid means antacids, ulcer protectives, anti H. pylori drugs. Now, classification of the drugs category wise, reduction of the gastric acid secretion, antacids, ulcer protective, ulcer healing drugs, anti H. pylori drugs are reduction of the gastric acid secretions. We can give H2 antihistamine, PPIs, anticholinergic drugs, PGNLO. In H2 histamines, we have the options of the cimetidine, ranitidine, famotidine, roxatidine. In PPIs, omeprazole, lansoprazole, pantoprazole, rabeprazole, dexamethasone. In anticholinergics, pyrazepine and propanthiolene. And oxyphenomen in PG or PG prostaglandin analog, we have misoprostol. We have two types of the antacids, systemic and non-systemics. Sodium bicarbonate, sodium citrate. In non-systemics are magnesium hydroxide, magnesium trisilicate, aluminum hydroxide, calcium carbonate. And ulcer protectives are sucralfate, colloidal bismuth subcitrate. Ulcer healing drugs are carbonazole sodium. And anti H. pylori drugs are antibiotics, which are amoxicillin, metronidazole, tinidazole, and tetracyclines. These are the drugs options for peptic ulcer disease. H2 blockers, PPIs, anticholinergic drugs, PG, prostaglandin analogs, and ulcer protectives, ulcer healing, and H. pylori drugs. These are very important type of the drugs. Now, anti-secretory drugs, S2 receptor antagonist, cimetidine, famotidine, ranitidine, or nizatidine. In active ulcer, we can give cimetidine 800 milligram at bedtime. And for maintenance therapy, we can give the 400 milligram at bedtime. And famotidine 40 mg at bedtime. And for maintenance therapy, we can give 20 mg at bedtime. Ranitidine or nizatidine group, we can give in case of active ulcer is 150 mg twice a day. And in case of the maintenance therapy, we can give 150 milligram at bedtime. Now, PPIs, lansoprazole, omeprazole, rabeprazole, lansoprazole we can give in case of the active ulcer 15 milligram for duodenal ulcer while 30 milligram for gastric ulcer. Omeprazole dose is 20 mg daily and rabeprazole group is we can give 20 mg daily in active ulcer. In prostaglandins analogs, misoprostol 200 microgram for 4 times daily. Now, agents enhancing mucosal defenses are antacids. What happens in antacids? They are weak bases and are salts of sodium, aluminium, calcium, or magnesium. When given orally, neutralize the acid secretion of the stomach, means they minimize the activity of the gastric juices, activity of the pepsinogens, damaging effects of gastric juice on ulcers. Thus promoting ulcer healing and pain relief. As I have told you that antacids classified as two types, systemic antacids and non-systemic antacids. Systemic antacids absorbed in the system while non-systemic antacids not absorbed in the system. Sodium bicarbonate is called, also called baking soda. Actions of the sodium bicarbonate in systemic antacids is in that stomach rapidly reacts and neutralizes the HCl. Carbon dioxide causes gastric distension and belching. NaCl and NaHCO3 in excess when passed into the intestine added with NaHCO3 of intestinal juice pass into the bloodstream where increase the pH of blood. They readily absorb in the bloodstream, alkalization of the urine affects renal clearance of the alkaline drugs. Excess NaHCO3 excreted results in pyrogenic polyuria and it can predispose of stone formation in the kidney, thus producing systemic electrolyte disturbances. In case of malfunctioning of the kidney, NaHCO3 accumulates giving rise to systemic alkalosis. NaCl increases the extracellular fluids volume and causes edema. This is very important. NaCl increases the extracellular fluid volume and causes edema. Now, advantages and disadvantages of the sodium bicarbonate. It is rapid in action. Carbon dioxide evolved gives a feeling of relief, alkalizes the urine, promotes excretion of the acid substances. And the disadvantage of this sodium bicarbonate is action is sharp. Carbon dioxide may be cause perforation of the ulcer. Stone formation may take place in the kidneys. NaCl absorbed can cause hypervolemia. Acute rebound phenomena may take place. These are the disadvantages and advantages of the sodium bicarbonate NaCl3. Now, in case of non-systemic, we can, number one is physicochemically acting. Aluminium hydroxide, magnesium hydroxide, magnesium trisilicate. Number two is chemically acting is calcium hydroxide, calcium carbonate, magnesium oxide, magnesium carbonate. And physically acting is milk and mucin. Now, actions of calcium carbonate. It may cause bilaching and metabolic alkalosis, promotes phosphate absorption, and there is a tendency for calcium phosphate stone. Excessive of sodium bicarbonate and calcium carbonate with calcium containing dairy products can lead to hypercalcemia, renal insufficiency, and metabolic alkalosis. It is also called milk alkali syndrome. Now, aluminium hydroxide, physicochemical acting, chemical actions are aluminium precipitate proteins in the intestine and leads to constipation. Small amounts of the aluminium can be absorbed and deposited in the brain, causing encephalopathies. Physical actions of aluminium hydroxide is it works as emulsifier and form a coat over the ulcer that thus promotes its healing. Aluminium absorb certain drugs in the intestine and reduce their bioavailability, like digitals, tetracyclines, and phenothiazines. Advantages and disadvantages of this aluminium hydroxide is, in case of advantages, action is prolonged and rebound secretion of the hydrochloric acid is less. It has neutralization and astringent effects. It absorbs certain drugs, toxins, and gases. And in case of disadvantages, the aluminium hydroxide is constipation may occur, loss of calcium from bones, formation of the kidney stones, decreased bioavailability of the certain drugs, encephalopathies with prolonged use. This is the action of the magnesium trisilicate. Silicon dioxide have demulcent effects. Silicon dioxide causes kidney stone formation. Unabsorbed magnesium salts can cause osmotic diarrhea. Advantages of this magnesium trisilicate is prolonged duration of the action, does not cause acid rebound, no disturbances in acid, base balance does not damage or perforate an ulcer, used as an adsorbent. And disadvantage of the magnesium trisilicate is laxative action, magnesium ions of the absorbed and kidney is not functioning, causes depression of the CNS, CVS, and neuromuscular junction, and renal stone formation, nephropathy. Sucralfate. In a water acid solution, sucralfate forms a viscous, tenacious paste that binds selectively to ulcers. Negatively charged sucrose sulfate binds to positively charged proteins in the base of ulcers, forming a physical barrier used on empty stomach. Not absorbed, no side effects, constipation. Now, the antibiotics, protectors of the mucous membrane of stomach and duodenum, mesoprostate, PGE1. It has both acid inhibitory and mucosal protective properties. It stimulates mucus and bicarbonate secretions, increase blood flow, binds to prostaglandin's receptor on parietal cells, reducing histamine-stimulated cyclic AMP, causing ACET inhibition. It reduces the incidence of NSAIDs, induced ulcers, reduces the incidence of ulcer complications 50%, diarrhea, abdominal pain, cramp, stimulate uterine contraction, not used in the pregnancy, is the adverse effect of the misoprostol. As I have already told you that the cimetidine, ranitidine, famotidine, nizatidine most commonly used in during the 1970 to 1990. Pharmacodynamics of the H2 receptors, they are highly selective act on H2 receptors, competitively inhibits the H2 receptor at parietal cell. Histamine 2 receptors, H2 blockers, reduce acid secretion through two mechanisms. Histamine released from enterochromaffin-like cells, ECL, by gastrin or vagal stimulation is blocked from binding to H2 receptors. Direct stimulation of the parietal cells by gastrin or acetylcholine has a diminished effect on the acid secretion in the presence of H2 blocker. They are especially effective as inhibiting nocturnal acid secretion, which depends largely on histamines. They have modest impact on meal stimulated acid secretion, which is stimulated by gastrin, acetylcholine, and histamine. Causes is more than 50% of the acid inhibition for 10 hours. Clinical uses are preventing of the gastric bleeding, gastroesophageal reflux disease, peptic ulcer disease, and non-ulcer dyspepsia. Cimetidine 30% of dose inactivated by liver, 400 mg BID or 800 mg at night. In case of the ranitidine, longer acting and 5 to 10 times more potent than cimetidine. 150 mg BID or 300 mg at night. Famotidine 20 to 160 times more potent than cimetidine. 20 mg BID or 40 mg HSR at night. Nizatidine similar to ranitidine, 150 mg BID or 300 mg at night. Now, adverse effect of the histamines. In adverse effects, headache, fatigue, confusion, hallucination, agitation, hypotension, bradycardia can occur. In cimetidine, inhibit binding of the dihydrotestosterone to androgen receptors, inhibit metabolism of the estradiol, and increases serum prolactin levels. So, cause gynecomastia or impotence in men, in galactorrhea in women. Very important side effect or adverse effect of the cimetidine. Now come to the PPIs, proton pump inhibitors. These are the dexlansoprazole, omeprazole, lansoprazole, rabeprazole, pentaprazole, and esomeprazole. They are introduced in late 1980, have resembles structure as H2 antagonist, but mode of action is completely different. All available in oral forms, esomeprazole and pentaprazole are also available in IV form. Now,
Mode of action of the PPIs. What are the mode of action?
They are inactivate product becomes active form to thiophilic sulfonamide in parietal cells. Cana liculus sulfonamides reacts with hydrogen H ion or K ion ATPase proton pump forms a covalent disulfide linkage and irreversibly inactivates that enzyme. Restoration of the acid secretion requires 18 hours for synthesis of the new pump. It's the old theory that proton pump inhibitors are always used in empty stomach, but nowadays there is some different ideas from WHO and FDA. So patient can use it with full stomach, or but is it good or ideal used on empty stomach undergo rapid, because undergoing rapid first pass and hepatic metabolism. Its half-life is 1.5 hours. Shorter half-life and duration of the acid inhibition is longer than 24 hours. Inhibit both fasting and meal stimulated secretions. As we can use it in GI, gastroesophageal reflux disease, peptic ulcer disease, H. pylori, or NSAIDs-induced ulcer, in non-ulcer dyspepsia, preventation of the stress gastritis, gastroma, and other hypersecretory conditions. These are the clinical uses of the proton pump inhibitors. Now, adverse effect of the PPIs. Taking of the proton pump inhibitors made diarrhea, headache, abdominal pain, and it can cause deficiency of the vitamin B12, reduce calcium absorption, increase the risk of the hip fracture. Hypochlorohydria causes increased risk of the enteric infections. Salmonella, Shigella. Potential problems due to increased serum gastrin. Hypergastrinemia can cause carcinoid tumor in reds. Now, drug-drug interaction. In case of PPIs, drug interaction may affect bioavailability of some drugs. Omeprazole may inhibit the metabolism of the warfarin, diazepam, and phenytoin. Esomeprazole may decrease metabolism of the diazepam. Lansoprazole may enhance clearance of the theophylline. These are the drug-drug interaction of the PPIs group. In case of the Helicobacter pylori, the antimicrobial agents or antibiotics are amoxicillin, clarithromycin, metronidazole, and tetracyclines. Amoxicillin is come in the name of the amoxil or trimox, and clarithromycin, vaccine, metronidazole, flagyl, tetracycline, and sumicin. We can use the drugs in eradication of Helicobacter pylori triple therapy. What do you mean by the triple therapy? It is two antibiotics plus one PPI. This therapy we can give for 10 to 14 days in case of the Helicobacter pylori infection. Omeprazole 20 mg BID in case of the Helicobacter pylori, and clarithromycinase we can give 500 mg BID. Amoxicillin 1 gram BID or metronidazole 500 mg BID, or last one option is tetracycline 500 mg QID. This is the drug plan for the Helicobacter pylori infection, also called as triple therapy, which is given 10 to 14 days. And we can continue the proton pump inhibitors for 4 to 6 weeks. Now, anti-muscarinic agents. Hyoscyamine, pyrazinamide, mepinazolate. These drugs inhibit the actions of the acetylcholine, thus reducing gastric motility and secretions. Used as adjuvant therapy with H2 blockers. The side effects of the antimuscarinic agents are dry mouth, blurred vision, constipation, urinary retention. Now, what to eat if you have peptic ulcer? In case of the peptic ulcer, the ideal food is bell peppers, cherries, apples, honey, olive oil, cauliflower, cabbage, green tea, and carrots. Now, which food is avoided if you have stomach ulcer? Alcoholic beverages, coffee or tea, carbonated drinks, red meat, salt and salty foods. These foods should be avoided in case of the ulcer. No doubt, lifestyle modification, discontinue NSAIDs, stop smoking, stop alcoholic beverages, and reduce stress. Thank you very much.